Bloodstained Lane, aka the Alex DeLarge of Queens, New York. Right. And on today's show, we're going to talk about a truly epic fight that took place this weekend at Sengoku Raiden Championships 14. And the fight I'm talking about is Jorge Santiago versus Kazuo Masaki Part 2. Now, for anyone who missed this fight, I suggest you go on YouTube right now and find this fight because it's easily one of the top 5 greatest fucking fights in MMA history. And before we go into the fight, I just want to say, earlier this year I did a video about the Korean Zombie Lennon Garcia fight that took place on a WEC pay-per-view this year. And I claim that that fight was the fight of the year and possibly one of the greatest fights of all time.
Now, it still is.
It still is one of the greatest fights of all time, but it's no longer the fight of the year. And I'm going to tell you why right now. While the fight was a great fight, it was pretty much a wild swing for the fences slugfest, which, you know, I appreciate. I love a good old-fashioned slugfest.
It's basically the MMA equivalent of Mickey Ward versus Ettore Gatti.
And that kind of fight appeals to the casual fans. The casual fans love a good old-fashioned slugfest. But for MMA purists, this Jorge Santiago Kazuo Masaki fight is the fight of the year. And the reason why it's the fight of the year, because it combined every fucking aspect of mixed martial arts you can think of. Striking, submission, submission defense, takedowns, survival skills. I mean, this fight was fucking, balls to the wall, a back and forth seesaw battle between two excellent mixed martial artists. And, man, I tell you the truth, I was falling asleep during that Akihiro Gono fight, but once this fight started, this fight gave me a new fucking life.
You didn't miss much in the Akihiro Gono fight. He got dominated.
I heard it was pretty bad. But you know what? Like I said, I was falling asleep, then the Masaki-Santiago fight started, and I woke right up. And I'm glad I did, because I witnessed fucking history that night. And, like I said, going into the fight, Santiago won the first one. So this was the rematch. And if you guys missed the first fight, go YouTube that, because that was a classic, too. You know, the fight began with both fighters pretty much, measuring each other out, not much going on. Round one was pretty much, Masaki just taking him down and working some ground and pound, and he definitely won the round one. Round two was more of the same, but then it started picking up a little bit. Masaki landed some brutal body shots, and then pulled guard and landed a guillotine that was so tight, I could have swore Santiago was going to tap out. Santiago showed some amazing survival skills and managed to survive that round. But, he was down 2 rounds going into the third. Round 3 was now, this is when things started really picking up. Both guys come out the corner, they're standing up. Fucking Jorge Santiago landed a Marius Zaramkis-like head kick, rocked Masaki, and he landed some fucking devastating ground and pound to almost finish Masaki in that round. I mean, the fight could have even been stopped. Came this close to being stopped.
Masaki did show great recovery.
He showed some great recovery, as he showed in his fight with Akiyama Yarunoka.
Yes, he got rocked.
Man, Masaki is a fucking warrior, man. I mean, this guy is the true definition of a fighter. For him to survive that barrage of devastation, man, they don't... Human beings like that, how many of them exist in this fucking world? I mean, he is a truly rare specimen.
Samurai
warrior. Round 4 was truly a fucking spectacle of a round. Masaki rocked Santiago with a devastating left hook, put him down, and then must have landed about 40 unanswered ground and pound punches. Jorge Santiago, man, another fucking warrior. Then Masaki mounts him. I think he took his back, scored a rear naked choke.
Yep.
Santiago survived that, was trying to scramble, and then Masaki pulled the guillotine. I mean, it was just the transition, the submission transitions going on in this fight, and the submission defense was, wow, top of the food chain Brazilian jiu-jitsu skills.
And also the heart shown by both guys. See that a lot these days.
Something. It was truly epic. Then after the beatdown that Santiago took in his round. Also, before I go into that, Santiago also was in so much trouble. He actually literally butt-scooted himself and almost pretty much jumped out the ring to survive the punishment that he was taking, which led to a red card and a point deducted. So now he's down 10-8 going into this round. But before the round ends, with 10 seconds left, this fucking guy rocks Masaki and puts Masaki down, and he's fucking starts scoring some ground and pound, and the round ends. What a fucking round of I can't even explain. You have to watch it to be seen. These guys showed every skill in mixed martial arts in this round, and the heart that they displayed was amazing. Going into the fifth round, they had Jorge Santiago down 39-36. So, you know, that was in my eyes. So, to win this fight, he needed a knockout or a submission. And, you know, as the round begun, you could see that Misaki was something, you know, he was out. He was faded. And I think Santiago smelled blood, and he came in and threw a barrage of fucking strikes. Ended up hurting Misaki. You know, Misaki goes down, and then for about 4 minutes, Santiago just punishes him with strikes from the mount. Transition after transition with submissions, rear naked choke, armbar, everything was being thrown at him. Misaki survived. Misaki actually even turned into his guard at one point during this
barrage. That was truly amazing.
It was truly amazing. You know, it ended with, you know, Santiago mounted again and landed some brutal, brutal ground and pound. And with 30 seconds left, Misaki's corner threw in the towel. Now, when this happened, I'm not gonna lie to you, I was a little fucking pissed off. I said, 30 fucking seconds left. Let the fucking guy finish the fight. You know, he was gonna win the fight. Even with the 10-8 round that Santiago was about to get, he still would have won the fight, in my opinion. And, you know, even Frank Trigger agreed with me. But, man, after they showed the footage of Misaki laid out on the fucking canvas, he looked like a fucking extra from Night of the Living Dead. He looked punished, beaten, and bloodied. And you know what? I couldn't complain with the stoppage. I mean,
well, we all know he wasn't going to quit. There's no quitting that guy.
He wasn't going to quit, and he was going to take more punishment with 30 more seconds, and the corner did the right thing, looking out for Kazuo Misaki. And you know what? The guy has nothing to hang his head about. He was part of one of the greatest mixed martial arts fights of all time with Jorge Santiago. A fight that will go down in history. A fight that will be loved by all MMA purists and hardcore fans to the very end. I mean, I can't say enough about this fight. What about you? What do you have to say?
It's one of the best fights of all time, no doubt about it.
I would say it's top three or top five. And like I said, for anybody who missed this fight, go YouTube and watch it right now. And, well, yeah, any other thoughts about that Sengoku card? Your boy that you liked fought.
Taisuke Okuno.
What'd you think about him?
Guy's a rising star in the sport, man. One of the best knockouts of the year on Nick the Goat Thompson. YouTube that as well.
Brutal knockout. I also want to shout out Hatsu Hayoki, who, man, fucking amazing grappler.
He made quick work of losses.
Shinya Aoki-esque, man. He just really, really showed that he's a top of the food chain submission artist in MMA. Probably a top five submission guy. I mean, he has his hands full with my boy, Marlon Sandro, who I feel is either number one or number two featherweight in the planet. It's either him or Aldo. So he has his hands full with that monster. But, man, the guy's definitely the real deal. Overall, it was a great Sengoku card. Mike Schiavello showed once again why he's one of the best commentators in MMA. Kept me, you know, he kept me up for most of the night, even though I was dead exhausted after watching Strikeforce and Sengoku. I pulled a fucking 9-hour MMA marathon.
Not to mention a taco run in between that.
Taco run into Brooklyn, Sunset Park we made in between. So I was a little bit tired, you know, but this is what hardcore MMA fans do. We live for the sport. We love the sport. And it was well worth the wait. The last match was well worth the wait. That being said, I just want to shout out my boy Anton Murevich from LowKick.com, and my boy Mike White, who started my Bloodstained Lane fan page on Facebook. You know, shout out to them. Bloodstained Lane, Team Takeover, you know what to do with your life.